Okay, this is not bad. No. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Imagine I'm in love with you. It's easy 'cause I know. I've imagined I'm in love with you many, many, many times before. It's not like me to pretend, but I'll get you in the end. Yes, I will, I'll get you in the end. Oh yeah, I think about you night and day. I need you and it's true. When I think about you, I can say I'm never, 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 never blue. So I'm telling you, my friend, that I'll get you in the end. Yes, I will, I'll get you in the end. Oh yeah, well, there's gonna be a time when you're gonna change your mind. So you might as well resign yourself to me. Oh yeah, imagine I'm in love with you. It's easy 'cause I know. I've imagined I'm in love with you many, many, many times before. So I'm telling you, my friend, that I'll get you in the end. Yes, I will, I'll get you in the end. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. All right, Johnny. Good for you. Good for you getting that song in there last second like that. You did it to me again, but it was a pleasure. Yes. Do you want to talk about the effects of smoking marijuana on the psyche? Yes. Just before you had a couple of hits, I said, remember how you feel right now. You feel hopeful, you feel energetic, and you feel reasonably chipper. Let's see how you feel after you smoke. Yeah, and I immediately started thinking, like, not terrible thoughts, but just like, I don't know, worrying thoughts. Yeah. So does that mean smoking marijuana makes you lean toward the paranoiac? Yes, you do. I do too. I do too, but not so much. No. But you're the opposite. You're the symbiosis of, you know, you that's how we fit together. So marijuana, I can handle more than you. I can just handle more than you. So I pick up the slack in that department, or however you want to put it. Well, that's always why I felt, I think, why, like when I was really partying heavy and drinking heavy, I was like, it's like I was drinking for two, I swear to God. Yeah. Yeah, well, me too, in my way too, you know. I couldn't really handle it. Comparatively, you handled it better than me. You remained more in control of yourself. I really lost control in a terrible way. Oh, I don't think you lost control in that of a terrible way, really. What was so bad, really? Whoa. This is gonna fall. No, you're fine. No, you don't think I did? No. Are you talking like Lost Weekend or any of that? I mean, everything you did was just your thing. That's what you did. You did stuff. So what? Everyone wants to talk because you just did stuff? So what? I did stuff too. Go fuck yourself, everybody. Why do I like you so much? I don't know. I really don't know. Which one's it gonna be, honey? Oh, gee. That one really? Yeah. You gotta do it. I was praying before, and John says, turn on the radio. I said, we're in the middle of a prayer. And he said, just turn it on. So I did. And this is the song that came on. Sister Christian, oh, the time has come, and you know that you're the only one to say, okay. Where are you going, what you looking for? You know those boys don't want to play with you no more. It's true. You're muttering, what's your price for flight? In finding Mr. Right, you'll be all night right tonight.
That's you holding my eyelid down. Yeah. Why are you doing that?
Babe, you know that you are growing up so fast. And mama's warning that you won't last. Let's play. Okay. Sister Christian, there's so much in life. Don't you give it up before your time is due. It's true. It's true.
They should have a countdown there, yeah.
True, yeah, motorist. What's your price for flight? You've got him in your sight. And driving through the night. What's your price for flight? In finding Mr. Right, you'll be all right tonight.
What a song to choose, Johnny. Yeah. But what, isn't that amazing that I was praying and this came on the radio? It's not so amazing, but it's worthy of sharing for certain, which is what I am doing. How are we? We're all right. We're fine. Come on, honey. Come on, Sister Christian. Yeah, sure. Here I go. Somewhere there's a picture of me in my communion dress. I'll never see that again, though.
Marin, what's your price for flight? In finding Mr. Right, you'll be all right tonight.
Gotta love it. The motorcycle goes just as this fucking song is. You're messing it up. No, I want them to hear the motorcycle.
Finding Mr. Right, you'll be alright tonight.
Oh yeah!
Sister Christian, oh, the time has come. And you know that you're the only one to say, okay. But you're motoring. Yeah,
that was a great ending, honey. Thanks. Thank God something was great. It's a hard song to sing. Good God. Hey, listen, can I complain when I want? Of course. Go ahead and complain. Who cares? These songs are a bitch, man. They're a bitch. I know. It's really true. Alice in Chains. Oh man, we got to do some Alice in Chains. Well, let's not get ahead of the game here. All right, you want to practice Alice? Yeah, we'll practice some Alice in Chains tonight. That sounds great. Yeah. Fucking A. All right, here we go. Here's the one we almost missed on the other day. We got cut off, but we're gonna do it up right now. A little Jackie Brown, right, honey? That's right, Lindy. Doctor, my eyes have seen the years and a slow parade of fears without crying. Now I want to understand. I have done all that I could to see the evil and the good without hiding. You must help me if you can. Doctor, my eyes, tell me what is wrong. Was I unwise to leave them open for so long? Sing it, baby. Thanks, hon. I love it. I love this guy. I have wandered through this world as each moment has unfurled. I've been waiting to awaken from these dreams. People go just where they will. I never noticed them until I got this feeling that it's later than it seems. Doctor, my eyes, tell me what you see. I hear their cries. Just say if it's too late for me. Sometimes you can't look at the way they do it on the karaoke. Yeah. Oh, yeah, 100%. If you know the lyrics, don't look at the screen. Right. That's the best way to do this song with this kind of, because their timing is all off with coloring the letters, and it's like something happens in my brain. Yeah. And you know this song, like the back of your hand. This one, you know. I know I do. I love this fucking song. Yeah. Jackie Brown. Doctor, my eyes cannot see the sky. Is this the price for having learned how not to cry? That's the kind of song that's a great ride for me. It's a great galloping ride, like my horsey up there. Everybody see the star of the horse's head? And you know, when you get a song like that, you feel like you're in the pocket, and then you feel like you have the energy to do more. Those other, you know, you throw that fucking, oh, please, Jackson, please. You throw that other Sister Christian at me, and it's like I'm brain dead in 5 seconds flat, ready to toss in my chips, or however the expression is. I love you. Hi, Tommy. He's going to get worse and worse, you know, the more you talk to him. And you've been talking to him a lot. He doesn't even know what to do with himself. You hear that ice cream man outside? Right. That's like the song in John's head. Like a carefree boy on a summer's day.
Is that true, John?
Yeah. That's why I don't get upset when you worry, because it's like, I'll snap her out of it eventually when she starts talking to me again. When do I start? Well, no, you've been doing really good. Just keep talking to me. All right. I'm talking to you right now. Please don't. I get very shy. I get very strange. Please don't take that personally. I wish you could see the way this woman rolls her eyes at me. Everyone. I wish you could all see it. All the hoodwinkers watching these YouTube videos, especially out there in Earthland. Earthland, yeah, back on the Vivarium. They're on the Vivarium. That's why you don't leave this place, you understand? No, I really, you gotta trust me, everything's under control. There's no place you need to be. There's nothing out there. All right, easy, does it there, Admiral, what's the guy's name
in that movie about them stuck on the space capsule thing? I forget. Mm. Well, there's a couple of those. I don't know any of them. Mm. I just know the premise. Room looks good tonight. Mm. We're preparing Easter. Good Friday is approaching quickly. And Easter Sunday, and it's just going to be a lovely season. It will also be marking exactly 6 years since I've been housebound, mostly bedridden. Mm-hmm. It will mark the 6-year anniversary of that this Easter. It happened on Easter in this room. Scene of the crime. Mm. Scene of the crime. Paralyzed, practically. Mm. Accidents in the home, right, Johnny? Mm-hmm. That's the truth. That is the truth. You know, I tell you, lucky it wasn't in the bathroom. Yeah, you're right. It could have gone. Because what happened is my leg collapsed. My leg collapsed, right. That's how the whole thing happened. And you don't see something like that coming. Not after being, you know, hoisting yourself around for all those years with a cane and a walking stick, whatever I needed. At the end, I had a knee scooter, a manual knee scooter, to get the leg off the ground. But You just don't see that it's going to just give way. That a limb is just going to give way. You hit it just right, and it'll go. Mm-hmm. And the result of that fall, of the leg going behind, collapsing, is that I dislocated, like, both shoulders. One of which was already fractured, but I wasn't aware that I was walking around with a fractured shoulder for a year or more. I only found that out later. I knew I had hurt it, but I didn't know it was that bad. So that's why when I say, you know, you got to sleep. You got to rest. You're up. You're doing. Honey, look at you. My God. You're a jumping bean. And I really can't get you to stop. And I don't want you to stop. What I do want you to stop doing is being so hard on yourself for not doing enough. It's bumming me out, honey. All right. What about now? I'm singing and everything. I know. That's helping a lot. I know. It's a workout. Yeah. It's a total workout. Getting the camera set up. And picking out, it's just, you know. And that's not even to say the physicality of it. This is very good exercise for me. Mm-hmm. My diaphragm, my back, my shoulders, my breathing. You have to super oxygenate if you sing like this. Same thing with the flute playing. See, and this is old Johnny prescribed stuff. He has been my mentor ever since. Forever, really, when I think of decisions that I've made in the past. I know he's had a lot to do with my lifeline. And vice versa, might I say. Yeah, you might say that. Will you? I don't know. We're like the English and gypsy, Englishmen and gypsy, Lucille Ball and Desi Arnaz. Yeah, we are a weird couple like that, right? We're like a Lucy and Ricky. We are so much, so much. That's crazy. Yeah. But you're the crazy gypsy girl and I'm the proper English gent. Yeah, but you're not that proper. I'm so whatever and would make you say that to me because I said it. You know me, I say stuff, yeah. Oh, no. Just keep talking. I'm talking, shut up. If you tell me to do that, I'm not going to want to talk. Do you want to sing a song? I want to just talk about how you've been my coach. Oh, right. You know I wanted to talk about that, yeah. And he, you know, he insisted I learn how to play the flute and all that good stuff. You know, stuff like he inspires me. Don't, you must not give up. You can do this. All right, you can't do that anymore. You can do this. You're going to do this. And then, you know, meaning the guitar mostly. That's like such a horrible feeling. Also that I have a brand new accordion. A brand new antique accordion, I should say. That's just been all fixed up. Accordion. I can't even imagine. I can't even, you know. Anyway. It's all coming. But the guitar has been an impossible thing. Really, I'm afraid of it because the pain is so bad. But the good news is that I have fallen in love with the flute. Yeah. And honey, you sing like a bird. When you can do that, it doesn't matter what else you can do. Really? Yeah. I could listen to you sing all day, all night, all the time. Well, maybe I'll do it. Will you do it right now? Thinking about it. What song you want to do? Listen to him. He gets excited, like sexually excited. I do. Guilty as charged. Yes. Oh, no. He's got me going tonight, folks. We got the hits. The hits are happening at this moment. You better take over, pal. Mama! Edward Lou Napoleon Day surrender. Warrior! And I have met my destiny in quite a similar way. The history book on the shelf is always repeating itself. Well, Waterloo, I was defeated, I won the war. Waterloo, love you forevermore. Waterloo, we're doing the chipmunks. Yeah. Waterloo. Knowing my fate would be with you. Whoa, 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 Waterloo. Finally face of my wall. Think about it. Those girls sound like the chipmunks. They do, I know. They totally do.
Mama, I tried to hold you, but you were stronger. Whoa, yeah. And now it seems my only chance is giving up the fight. And how could I ever refuse? I feel like I win when I lose.
Waterloo, I was defeated, you won the war. Waterloo, promise to love you forevermore. Waterloo, who did this baby where I want to? Waterloo. Knowing my fate will be with you. Whoa, 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 Waterloo. Finally facing my Waterloo.
So how could I ever refuse? I feel like I win when I lose.
Waterloo, couldn't escape if I wanted to. Waterloo, knowing my fate could be with you. Whoa, 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 Waterloo. Finally facing my Waterloo. Whoa, 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 Waterloo. Waterloo, 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 Waterloo.
All right. Good God. That is so funny. That is such a chipmunk song. Yeah. Do the Christmas chipmunk song for me. All right. I gotta look at the altar for this. Oh, I almost dropped this. Fuck. Hi, Mother and Father. You're on. All right.
Christmas time is here. time for love and time for cheer. Christmas, Christmas time for you. With fun for me and fun for you. Christmas,
something.
Me, I want.
John, don't mess up. Oh.
Me.
That's it.
Me, I want a hula hoop.
I don't know the words. All right.
Da, 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 da. Me, I want a hula hoop. We can hardly stand the wait. Oh, Christmas, don't be late. We can hardly stand the wait. Oh, Christmas, don't be late.
You know what's the most... Hi, Mom and Dad. Hey. You know what's the most amazing thing to me about that? How loud you get in that tonal quality. You have such a blast in that tonal quality. It's really quite ear-splitting, really.
Really?
Yeah. To me, out here it is. Maybe not so much. No, I feel it in my ears when I do that. I do. You're right. Mm. Yeah, it's funny. Certain vibratos or whatever. Yeah, that'll happen. That's when the dual vocal cords kick in, the twin flame vocal cords. We sing like one big ass stereo. We're like the two monos became a stereo. What's a good song to what's that song I'm thinking of just now, the stereo? Oh, life's a strange living in stereo. We got to do some Cars, yeah. Well, we did Best Friend's Girl. Yeah, that's true. But we'll do some more Cars because we love the Cars, right, honey? Hell yeah. I used to watch you doing aerobics to those Cars albums.
Really?
Yeah. It's fucking crazy, man. You're kidding. No, why would a kid think I'm lying here or something? Listen to how he talks. He's so snotty and snide. Mm. I love it. There's my girl. See? He likes when you're mean to him. Not really. Oh, he's snorting. Oh, what does that mean? It means the snort of... humiliation. Really? The snort of humiliation. Okay. Every once in a while, that snort would come out of me, right? Not a lot, but a lot of times when I was hanging out at the park with my friends, and that snort would come out, and my friends would always die laughing, like, oh my God, that noise when she makes it. And it's totally John. John snorts like that. That's his thing. Mm-hmm. Some big ones when he laughs, but... And I realize now then those were weird times too that I felt like not myself. Like, what, you know, what kind of, I'm a weird person. Mm. What's wrong with me? Why, I don't know if I like it being this way and why am I like this? Or other times I would just be like, wow, where did that come from? You know, after a particularly good session jamming with people or something, I'd feel particularly electrified, you know? Well, that's how it always felt for me when I was channeling you back then. Always. Until it didn't anymore. When would you say that it felt like that back, before Hamburg? I was with you. And I was with you. Having a ball. Having a crazy-ass ball. Literally. Bowling everything in sight and having you on the side there. Yeah, right. That's nice, John. Well, it's not like you mind it. What if I just started bowling everything in sight right now? See, it's not the same now. The circumstances is completely different. You were all for it. You were like, you know, helping me pick them out.
Mm-hmm.
I know this is a review of sorts, but so And I you know that I'm asking just theoretically, that I have no desire to. I couldn't imagine being physical at this point with anyone, no matter how nice they are. Because you belong to me. That's correct, honey. Well, that's how I felt too. But men are different. I didn't get around all that much, you know. All right. I told you it's pretty even, you and me, statistically speaking, our history of philandering, if you want to call it that. Okay. Marriage we had both those marriages, and between those marriages and our side projects, I guess, it's the same. We really match up so much, Lena. I never got around any more than you did. And guess what? I didn't enjoy it any more than you did either. Really? Don't men have to kind of enjoy it? Yeah, that can happen, sure, but it can make you feel pretty shitty about yourself afterward, too. Oh, that's terrible. Don't say that. I don't want you to feel like that. Well, I'm trying to put it all behind me now. Are you just saying this so that you can get sympathy or something? Yes. It worked. How you liking that show, Me, Her, You? It is... You, me, and her. Right. Just remember the me is in the middle. I'll try my best, baby. How do I like it? I love it. It's so stupid. It's retarded. Yeah, it's great. The fucking folks you love to hate. There's so much hateable on this show. I can't bring this to the public eye. They have to go look at it themselves. You deserve this. If I gotta watch it, you gotta watch. Honey, I love you. I love you too. Did you want to do one more song? Or it's like 32 now. But I do like sitting up and being active while I can. And I'm not feeling as much pain as I was yesterday. I'll tell you what, too, you're going to sleep like a baby tonight. And don't get scared off the Benadryl. Every once in a while, you have one. But yeah, back off a little bit on those. All right, Benadryl. I do take them for allergies before bed because they do knock you out. But they are kind of like a sleeping pill. I knew it was too good to be true. I knew it was too good to be true. It's not a big deal, honey. It's not a big deal. And you're in such great shape. You know, nutritionally and everything. So I don't want you to panic about that now either. But you don't need it. And we got some holistic stuff coming. So, all right. Billy Joel coming in for one last swoop. Yeah. Well, not the last one, you know. Yeah, but Billy Joel is here tonight. Hi, Billy. Hey, how you doing? I'm impressed. You're really going for it. Well, gotta try, right? Hi, everyone on Channel Z tonight, brethren, mother, father, everybody, and Virginia. Come out, Virginia, don't let me wait. Your Catholic girl's starting much too late. Ah, but sooner or later it comes down to fate. I might as well be the one. Well, they showed you a statue, told you to pray. They built you a temple and locked you away. Ah, but they never told you the price you would pay for things that you might have done. Darling, only the good die young. That's what I said. Only the good die young. Only the good die young. You might have heard that I run with a dangerous crowd. We ain't too pretty, we ain't too proud. We might be laughing a bit too loud, but that never hurt no one. So come on, Virginia, show me a sign. Send up a signal, I'll throw you a line. The stained glass curtain you hide behind that never lets in the sun. Darling, only the good die young. So this is a definite theme this evening. Are we can say that? Yes. It's amazing how you put these shows together. We did Sister Christian, and now he's singing about Catholic girls starting much too late. And now, and you talking about our youth and our, discretion or indiscretions. So there's a theme here tonight. Yeah. And that theme is you are forgiven. Well, so are you, right? Yeah, we're all forgiven. Mm-hmm. But, you know, it's a lot of work getting rid of that guilt. Mm-hmm. But I want you to start enjoying yourself a little bit more. All right. And I know I'm a broken record, but I really want you to stop equating every pain with the end of the world. You're shell-shocked, honey. You got post-traumatic stress disorder that it deserves a new categorization, honey. But I'm here to give you the tough love and just tell you that you got to relax a little bit more. And I'm here to help you do that. All right. I'll help you. Christopher's helping you. I know. I don't know what we would do without. Well, we don't do without Christopher because he's part of the team. Now, carry on. Whoa, 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 whoa. Only the good die young, only the good die young. Well, you got a nice white dress and a party on your confirmation. You got a brand new soul and a cross of gold. Yeah, Virginia, they didn't give you quite enough information. Oh, you didn't count on me when you were counting on your rosary. Whoa, they say there's a heaven for those who will wait. Some say it's better, but I say it ain't. I'd rather laugh with the sinners and cry with the saints. The sinners are much more fun. Oh, darling, only the good die young. Ah, yeah, baby. I want to ask you a question. All right. Do you think you'd rather laugh with the sinners than cry with the saints? Yeah, but that's the kicker. The saints ain't crying. The saints are having a grand old time marching in, honey. That's, you know, that's the joke of this song. The punishment, the guilt, let's go. All right. Only the good die young. Only the good die young. Way to wreck a horn solo. Thanks. It's boring. Everybody knows this song. I mean, I'm sorry, Billy. Yeah. Said your mother told you all that I could give you was a reputation. She never cared for me. But did she ever say a prayer for me? Whoa, come out, come out, come out, Virginia. Don't let me wait. That girl's got but. And there's your mother never counted on me, right, honey? lest we forget. Yeah. Yeah, my biological family sure did not count on John. Mm. Or maybe they did. There was like a real fear in them when John started coming through. And I don't think it was for my mental health. They never had a fear for my mental health. They always counted on me being not well. Mm-hmm. That was not a concern of theirs, my mental health. Never. I know, honey. And that's why this song is kind of funny, because, you know, she didn't count on me.
Right.
So why ain't you laughing?
Because it's sickening.
Mm.
It's sickening the way the whole thing played out.
Yeah. But you're strong. You're so much stronger now, my God. Mm. And I, you know, and I have you to thank, and I have sobriety to thank. I have God and Mother to thank. I also have Christopher to thank. He's an unbelievable friend and caregiver. Special seat in him. It's a special seat up there. You too, honey. You took good care of him when he was dying.
Yeah.
We did. And we continue to look out for each other and each other's interests, and
and pull our weight. I think I pull my weight, honey. You do. It's time you realize you do. Mm. Well, I think I'm trying to realize that right now. Yes. You're hungry. Yeah, we have that salmon left. I can't wait. I know, I'm hungry too. And I'm really thirsty. We got to get some water up in here. Mm-hmm. Listen, sir, I love you, and we love everyone, mother and father. Any words, Mom? No, and stop beating yourself up about the cards, would you please? You don't need a deck of cards in your hand every minute of your life. Let's look at the altar for a moment. All right, you have a couple of hearts up there. You got this crucifix. You got an eight. So I'm going to say infinity. Christ has risen. Love eternal. And everyone should be kicking it up a notch for the, you know, this season, the Advent, the ascension, the resurrection, the crucifixion. Yeah. Thank you, Mom. Yeah. And by doing, and but go ahead, Lena. And by that, she means everyone should be really kicking it up a notch and giving to a charity, volunteering and doing something to that effect. Do it. If you only have $5, do it, that you can spare. But I know anyone watching this video has more than $5 to spare. Give to a shelter or an organization. So many. Look at our page. You got a million links. Do it.
Mm.
God needs that from you. Right, honey?
Yeah.
So true. All right.
Ready?
Yeah. Off we go. Let's go out on a song. All right.
Sooner or later it comes down to fate. I might as well be the one. You know that only the good die young. Tell your baby. Only the good die young. Only the good die young. Only the good. Only the good die young. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
You were young. You were the good dying young.
Yeah.
I'm hanging around a bit. Don't be so sure. You're hanging. What do you? What, now time to get nervous again. Remember, you were fine before you took the reefer. So what are you saying? I'm saying you should go back to your original promise to yourself that you were only going to have one or two hits tops.
Yeah, but once we I know, I kind of get greedy with it. I do.
Mm-hmm. I feel like I'm all right. You're fine.
Don't sweat it.
Okay. And you know, I wasn't that good to die young. You were pretty good.
Nah.
You saw my shortcomings. Mostly my shortcomings with you that I had issue with was those fur coats. That was really an abomination, yeah.
All right. We'll talk about this later.
All right.
I love you.
I love you too.
We'll talk about this later?
Yeah. It doesn't have to be on film. I don't care about the film. I'm dying to put this camera down.
All right.